Learn how to keep your Azure subscription clean in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. Most teams that work in an Azure subscription forget to delete unused resources. This makes it difficult to see which resources are still being used, and it makes you pay for resources that you don't use. Here, for instance, I have an Azure storage account that I don't use. Let's clean that up with a script. This is a PowerShell script. It cleans up unused resources. The first thing the script does is log into Azure using a service principle. We'll see how we can use one of those later on. And next, I use the Azure resource graph to get the resources that should be cleaned up. Unfortunately, there is no easy way to determine which resources should be removed, so we need users to create a tag for those resources. A tag called expireOn with a value of the date when it should expire. Here I get all resources with a date that is earlier than today. The script loops over the resources and removes them. And finally, because Azure Resource Graph doesn't return resource groups, we get all of those and iterate over them. And when a resource group is empty, it gets deleted. Okay, tagging resources is easy. You can do it in the portal with the Azure CLI or in an Azure Resource Manager template. Here I can add a tag to the storage account, expire on, and the date should have the format year, month, day. And that's it. Okay. To automate the process, we'll run the script with Azure Automation. Let's create an Azure Automation account. There we go. First, I'll give it a name. And next, I'll select a resource group. And I'll leave this. This creates the service principle that the script uses to log into Azure. Okay, I'll skip to when it is done. Here is the Azure Automation account. The script uses PowerShell modules that aren't installed by default, so we have to install them first. Click on Browse Gallery, and we can pick them from here. First, I need AZ accounts. That is this one here, and import it. Next, search for AZ resource graph that we use to query the resource graph. Okay, import it. And finally, search for AZ resources. That's it. And now import this as well. Okay, let's skip to when these are imported. Now we'll create a runbook. This is the mechanism that we use to run the PowerShell script in Azure. First, give it a name. Okay. And select PowerShell for the runbook type. And create. Alright, this is the runbook. Now paste in the script, like this. And save the runbook. And publish it so that we can use it. Done. To make it run automatically, I'll add a schedule to it. There we go. And create a new schedule. Also give this a name. Okay. And now select a start date and time. And I'll tell it to recur every 1 day. And that's it. Okay. This will run the script every day. I can also run the runbook to test if it works. Let's do that. And here it goes. This can take a while to spin up. And it is done. And it ran successful. So now, when I look at my resource group, the storage account is removed. The script worked. It is important to remove unused Azure resources to keep your costs in check and your Azure subscription clear. You can do it with a script and automate it with Azure Automation. Go and try it out.